and metric system of units we apply to measure the mass and weight. And today we're going to learn about measurement of time. What are going to talk about? Measurement of time. Measurement of time. You know well about that time. How to measure the time? Is that clear? Yes. Time is an interval between two events. Time is an interval between two events. Is it or not? So a time decides a period of gap. Is it? Then how to measure nowadays time? By using different type of devices. From our ancient time and now, if you observe carefully, in our ancient time there was estimated the time with a different type of weight by the identification indications of the sunlight and direction of the sun, sand clock, water clock, okay? And also they were utilized what we can wristwatches, and nowadays we are going by wristwatches, okay? Pendulum clock, pendulum, quartz clock, solar clock, it's a different digitalization, digital clock, different type of are there. So by that we are getting a exact time by the digital. We may get exact time by the digitalization. Coming to that, what is the mean and how to measure the time to talk about that? Let me talk about that. Time is the interval between two events. Time is a interval between two events. Two events. But the gap between two successive modes means the gap, the duration it shows between the two successive continuation gap. We may ask whether period finished or not. What is the time? And a particular event when you may get in a television. What is the time to go for birth? What is the time to ready? What is the time? What is the time? Like different ways we can. See, that's why the gap between two successive, the gap between two successive, what we can call noon is called, what we can call solar day. What is that? Solar day. Solar day means what we are calling a complete day, means a gap between two successive. Successive means continuous. Successive means continue, one after one. One after one. One successor is a two. One successor is a two. Means we have to add one to the one, it becomes two. Successor, predecessor. We may learn in your mathematics, I think so. Is it? So, between two successive noons, successive noon, continue noon, what we call that is a solar day. So today afternoon 12 o'clock, then tomorrow afternoon 12 o'clock, this between gap is what we are calling solar day. Today afternoon 12 p.m. and tomorrow 12 p.m. Complete duration of those day, what we are calling solar day. What is that? Solar day. The average of all solar days, what we can say, the average of all solar days, in which the Earth completes, Earth completes one revolution around the sun is called, mean solar day. What we can call mean solar day. So solar day means we discussed the continue the gap between it is period of gap means period of successive time means successive nouns. Successive nouns, what we call the gap between successive nouns, we call solar day means total average. So the average of all solar days, average of all solar days throughout the year, throughout the year, the complete year, the whole solar days, the average total average solar days by finishing one complete revolving solar, it takes 1 year, 365 days, 365 solar days, 365 solar days. By taking average, that we can call mean solar day. What we can call that? Mean solar day. Okay? The mean solar day is the mean solar day is mean solar day is divided into 24 equal divided into 24 equal 24 equal intervals equal interval and each interval is and each interval is each interval is further divided what we can each interval is called hour. What is the mean of hour? See, the mean solar day is divided into 24 equal interval day intervals. See, solar day means what? Successive noons, the gap between successive noons from today afternoon to tomorrow afternoon, that is complete solar day. Means see here, the solar day, how many are there? There is a 365 days because Earth taking 365 days to revolve from around the sun. Okay, that each solar day divided into 24 equal parts, equal intervals. Means each interval is equal to the gap. Each gap interval is same. So that each interval we are calling as a hour. What we are calling that? A hour. Again, that hour is divided into 60 equal parts. How like C1? One hour is further divided into 60 equal parts called minutes. What you can call minutes. See that carefully, is that visible to you? Yes. Coming to talk. So again, hour divided into 60 equal parts or 60 equal intervals. 60 equal intervals, those we called minutes. Again, minutes also divided into 60 equal intervals that we called as a second. Coming to that, what we can see once, 1 minute is further divided. 1 minute is further divided into 60 equal intervals or equal parts called second. See carefully what we written to you. What is the solar day? What is the mean solar day? What is the hour? What is the minute? What is the second? Okay? Note down that. Yeah, finish that. We learn about solar day, mean solar day. At the same time, hour, minute, second. After that, what is now already the relation to that? That we learn. What we know that we can learn that. So I have to keep learning for online test, because what you are finishing, that only we may get in your online test. Understand? Throughout the week, what you are finishing, that only we can practice. See here, one mean solar day, one mean solar day is divided into 24 hours. Is that clear? 1 hour is equal 1 hour is equal 60 minutes. At the same time, 1 minute is equal 60 seconds. See here what we can, 1 second is equal 100 milliseconds. 1 second is equal 100 milliseconds. Remember that. So what we can, number of seconds in one mean solar day, See here, how many seconds per 1 mean solar day? 1 mean solar day. What we can say here, 20 means 24 hours, 60 minutes, 60 seconds. Is that clear? How many hours are there? 24 hours are there per hour, 60 minutes per minute, 60 seconds. Means by multiplying those, what is that? 24 into 60 into 60. 6 is 360. 6 is 36 and 2 zeros. And 24. 4 0 0 0 24 and 12 14 and 2 0 0 12, so 6 7 0 0 4 6 8 86,400 seconds. Understand? 86,400 seconds. What are those? What we can say? For one solar day, means in one day, for how many 24 hours, how many seconds? For one day, how many seconds? 86,400 seconds. Then 1 second is equal. What we can write? 1 second is equal. What we can write, ma? 1 second, then 1 second is equal, by transferring this side, what we can, 1 by 86,400, the part of a mean solar day, means what we can say, part of a mean solar day by 86,400. solar day by 86,400. Okay, coming to that, what we can talk about that here. Then next thing is 1 by 24th part of the mean solar day is called hour. What we can call 1 by 24th part, 1 by 24th part of the mean solar day, of the mean solar day is called hour. Because of how many hours per day? 24 hours. So for what we can, 1 hour is equal 1 by 24 part of the mean solar day. From here, 1 hour is equal 24 by transform you said, one known mean solar day by 24. 1 minute is equal what we can write, 1 hour by 60. Everything we can write similarly to that. See here, what we can, 1 hour is equal 24 by transferring this side, solar day by, what we can write, solar day by 24. The same time, so 1 minute is equal, 1 minute is equal, so hour by 60. So second is equal, second is equal minute by, minute by 60. Okay, like we can write that only we are writing. Okay, like only we return to that. Understand? So we return from multiples to sub multiples, multiples to sub multiples. Understood? And one more thing, what we can write here, see carefully, 1 by 1440th part of the mean, part of the mean solar day is called mean solar day is called minute. What we can say, minute. Because of, why? Because we called that, one solar day is equal to, one solar day is equal 24 hours 60 minutes. 24 hours 60 minutes means by that multiplication, what we can get, 6 4 24, okay, 12 and 14, so 0 minutes. So 1 minute is equal, 1 minute is equal solar day by 1440. That only we written upside. Is that clear to you? Okay. We compared how like those we written. How like those we written. Same as to that, what we can write, second is a considered as the standard unit of a time. Second is a, what we can write, second is the unit, means standard unit. How like that? Standard unit. Standard unit to measure the time. To measure the time. So time, second is a fixed constant unit or standard in SI or whatever. It is fixed unit to measure the time. Second is a standard unit to measure the time. Understand? And it is called, means what we can, second is, before written, hour means 1 by 24th part of the mean solar day is called 1 hour. 1 by 1440th part of the mean solar day is called minute. Same as, so what we can write, second is a 1 by, what we can, 1 second is equal, what we written, 1 by 86,400 the part of the mean solar day. Means, 1 by 86,400, the part of the mean solar day is called second. What we can call? That is a second. Understand? No doubt though. Now finish. Yeah, coming to talk about, so what we learn about solar day, mean solar day, hour, minute, second, how those are equal to each and every part, is it or not? And coming to that further, big units of time to know, to learn about. Up to now what we know, those only we learn how to measure the time. Some more are there big units to measure the time. What are those? See here. Further bigger units of time are further big units to measure the time. What are those big units to measure the time? Those are year, what is that? Year, decade, okay, and century. Century, millennium, okay? What I'm saying, these are the big units to measure. Year is equal to 365 days, okay? And decade means 10 years. So century, 100 years, and millennium, 1000 years. Okay? Means what we can write for each thing, see, one century means 100 years, means what we can, 100 years means 10 into 10 years we can write, 10 into 10 years, 100. So 10 years what we can call, 10 years one decade. So 10 years we can call one decade, means 10 decades, what we can call 10 decades. Means one century we can call as a 100 years of the same as 10 decades. 10 decades. Same as to talk about here. So coming to talk about that, what we can, 100 years means we can talk, 100 means what we can, 10 into 100 years. 10 into 100 years means 10 into 100,000 years. So 10, 100 years, what we can call century. So what we can write century, what we can call century. Otherwise, we can write millennium means what we can call 10 century. Otherwise, one millennium means 100 into 10 years. 100 into 10 years means what we can 100. 10 years is equal decade, so 100 decades, 100 decades. Millennium means 10 centuries we can write, otherwise 100 decades. Okay, note on that. Finished. Coming to that, next thing to write. So already we know that 1 hour is equal 60 minutes, 1 minute is equal 60 seconds. Is that clear? Some part of the units of time, what we can, some practical units, practical units of time in various branches of physics. What are there? Then see here. These are not in SI units. Okay? Coming to talk about one shake. One shake is equal 10 to the power of minus 8 seconds. Next thing is 1 minute is equal 60 seconds. Okay? 1 hour is equal 60 minutes. Means we can write 60 minutes. Otherwise, we can write 60 into 60 is equal 3600 seconds. 1 minute all are there. 1 minute all are there. What we can write? 1 into 24 hour. Okay. Means what we can say? So 1 into 60 minutes means so 1440 minutes. Then 14 into 40 into 60 seconds. So what we can write for that? 86,400 seconds for 1 day. Okay, understood. Coming to that next, 1 month. What we can write for that? 1 month. 1 month is equal, what we can write for that? 30 days. What we can? 30 days. Generally, we are considering 30 days. Those are appears in April, June, September, and November. Where it will appear in April, June, September, and November. So in this month we may get 30 days. Month is equal 31 days. We can consider. Generally we are considering 30 days, but 31 days in remaining. January, March, May, July, what we can write in that month? January, okay, March, and next, after that, April or the May, June or the July, August, September or the November or the December. In this month, we may get those. And next, in 1 month, 29 days. Is that clear? Generally, we may get 28 days. Okay. This is general preserve. What you can? General preserve. And next, 1 month is equal, we can get 29 days. It is a leap year in February. Leap year in February at every 4 years after. 4 years after, at every 4 years after. What you may get at every 4 years after. 4 years after you may get one leap year. Understand? Not on that. And one more thing, we can write that what we can lunar month. What we can lunar month. Lunar month, 4 weeks. What we am writing? 4 weeks, generally 27.3 days approximately. What we can? 27.3 days approximately. What we can? Approximately. Okay, and coming to that, 1 year. 1 year is equal to 365.25 days. Generally, we are considering 365 days. Okay. Note on those. You have finished that? So keep learning what you are finishing for practice online test. So see you in the next class. Have a good day to you.